Yeah. Yo, this is cool. Okay, so now have you stopped being an artist? Or now let's talk about this Chapa remix, because you talked about
Blackstar. Yeah, so it's like I'm doing a bit of both. Where I get an MC gig, I MC. Where I get a performing gig, I perform.
You're still being called as a performer?
Yeah. So now at this stage, it's like I created a new revenue stream still within entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
I'm saying.
So I'm earning from both. And then I came to realize later that MCing pays more and requires less investment.
Mm.
I don't need to shoot music videos. Mm-hmm. I just do a media tour. Now I'm living off my brand. My last MC gig that I did, that I did a video and took photos, is what I'll post to market for my next clients. Like, I don't have to shoot videos and do songs. And I'll be paid even more than the artists.
Okay, bro.
Do you understand? Like, artists were being paid, what, 50, 70, 70K at the time? It reached a point now where I was earning a sock, 150, 2 sock, 250. You get what I mean? So
yep.
It's grown.
Yep.
So I learn more than the artist.
Okay.
Because anyway, I spend more time on stage than the artist.
Yeah, yeah, you do. You do.
Because I'm the holder of the event. Yes, I'm exactly. The master of ceremony.
Mm-hmm. I get it. Yeah. And you're the one who's truly bringing the ROI in terms of
pushing the product.
Exactly. The artists have brought the people there.
That's what I understood now. And based on that, it became a bargaining chip with brands. So I kept pushing. So I worked with two black.
Sweet. Because you're like, look at my record, it speaks. Yes. I step on that stage, your ROI goes up.
And then you see now, the more gigs you do, your roster becomes like solid. So now I've already finished proof of concepts at the MC stage. I'm now showing clients, look at the brands I've worked with. So now getting into a boardroom, I'm name dropping. I just did Viceroy, I've done Tusker, I've done Coke, I've done this, I've done that, I've done. So surely you have to pay, and the rate is this. So the rate has always been.
Have you said no to a lot of people?
Yes.
What gives you the strength
to say? I said no even during COVID. Missy, I mean, kitu kama bea corona. Because my
I love it.
My lifestyle yesterday and change. Where you see me here, where you find me is where you find me tomorrow, inshallah.
Yep.
I've not downgraded because of COVID. In fact, I'm buying nice shoes, importing from the US, the UK. I'm investing more now. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I'm about growth. I don't feel like because there's a pandemic, I need to slash my rate card to 1/10 of my rate or 1/8.
So let me ask you, okay.
This my rate is the same.
Now, you guys, DNG, I'm glad you're sitting
and,
where you are.
And even if one client says they cannot afford me, I'll find another client.
That's my question. In fact, that's what I was going to ask you. People are scared of saying no because of desperation of that money at that time.
Correct.
And sometimes it's genuine. You're broke. You have zero bob in your pocket.
Yeah.
This car, 100 Gs. My rate is 300 Gs. This 100 Gs is going to pay my rent for this month.
Straight.
It's the 29th, bruh. I've seen a rent.
Mm.
You get, I'll do this gig on Saturday. I get that money Saturday evening.
Yeah.
I'm good.
Yeah. So what that does, it devalues your rate. It devalues your brand. So any client who, let's say, had been paying you, and then the industry, you know, our industry is this small.
Yeah.
Everyone talks to everybody.
Mm.
It's a very small ecosystem. And once people know that you're a cheap artist, as they like to talk, they offer you peanuts. So that's why we have big names in this industry who I do not want to embarrass in this platform, who are being paid very little money. Big names, and you know them.
Hmm.
We can talk about them, and they know themselves. Big names earning 50K. Big names. It's an embarrassment to the entertainment industry. Because the same client who's paying you 50K will pay another artist 1 million.
So
1.5 million. So if you sold have a rate card of 1.5 million shillings.
Mm.
You know that.
Yep.
That's $15,000.
They don't.
So by the time you're sharing a stage with Sauti Sol, they are being paid 1.5 and you are earning 50, don't you feel stupid about your brand? You know what I mean?
Mm.
And I'm not saying that every artist now is on Sauti Sol level.
Yeah.
Big shout out to Sauti Sol. I've toured with them, man. Their work ethic, their stage performance. Me, Ata, as an MC, I used to shook her down and watch the show like a fan.
Mm.
I love their music. And their stage performance is incredible. And they'll do 1 hour and a half 30.
Bien chukua simu.
Let's do it again. I toured with them, like two story.
What
Live and Die Africa tour.
Oh, you're the one who was the MC for that?
Yeah, can't tour.
So they hired you?
Yes. Do you understand?
First and foremost, that's why they should be charging 1.5M.
Yeah.
They hired you.
They hired
you.
DNG,
are getting your paycheck
hiring,
from them.
We had a DJ. I forget. DJ Kaffee was our DJ. Alongside others, they had cutting razors. They had sponsors. We are in top hotels. We never lalad in a lojo. When my birthday for turning 30 years, I celebrated at English Point Marina, courtesy of South Isol.
Live and die.
And then after that, tukaenda Swahili Beach.
What?
To celebrate success ya hiyo tour. You understand? Like that, those, that brand of these boys is next level, man. I have not seen an entertainment outfit as prolific as South Isol Entertainment.
DNG, what made you say no? Okay, I've heard about the devaluing, but yeah. When you're broke, I'm asking this for the guy who's broke right now and has been offered some bit
20K.
Of yes, and
appearance.
He knows. And I'm just this is not a guy who's exposure needs exposure or anything. This is a guy who's he's done his time. He's earned a few of his stripes.
Yeah.
So maybe his fee is 250, but he's been offered 70K for this gig, and he needs that 70K. Mm.
I think it's a personal choice, Esther, because different brands price differently. Even if you go to a supermarket, come on, let's say Maji. Kuna brands mingi za Maji. Kuna Maji ya 20 bob, na kuna Maji ya 50.
Ah, I get what you mean.
Eh, hey, ziko. Ada kama ni pombe. Kuna
like
pombe ya,
in fact,
ya sombili.
They called Veblen goods.
Ama kuna kikombe ya 20. Na kuna mzinga ya 50 tao.
Bentley are not changing their price
King
for
George.
You.
You know what I mean? Hey, kuna kandai ka susaba.
Peponi
kuna,
is not changing its price for you.
Hey, niliona sijui mapero anapeleka shule fulani, Brookhouse, kotini. Koti kawambia, kama ufiki bei peleka public school.
Na ziko.
Usianze kupigana. Bei ziko, options ziko. What I'm saying is, as an industry, we have to reach a point where we value our craft so much that we are able to stick and stand firm about our rate cards. It's the only way we will grow our rate cards and build our industry. Where Kenyan artists have been challenged a lot. You know, why aren't you investing in top quality videos? If you're earning 70K, when will you ever shoot a top quality video? That's why standard, I grow. But for the artists who are earning money, they're plowing back in the game. You see, that's how it works. So like, you know, people are talking about management. I want to have a manager. You know, I was talking to an agency media buyer the other day, and she was like, some of these influencers I'm dealing with do not even know how to prepare an invoice. They are not even pre-qualified. They started working without an LPO. So how do you pay them? People don't have business acumen. They don't have the training. Or even if they don't have the training, they cannot employ people to do that work for them. Because they can't afford it. If you've been paid 10K to post a beer brand on social media.
Exactly.
At what point are you going to get a PA or an assistant or a manager to do your invoice?
Bruh, I love what you're saying.
So, by the time the professional experience is coming to the table, a client expects me when I'm coming for a gig to have prepared to do scripts, prep. I'm coming to do sound check. We have perhaps even a dry run where there's a production, okay? Sometimes dry runs are 1-2 days depending on the complexity of the event. I can't charge you 20,000.
It's true.
I can't charge you what I used to be paid in 2006. That means my brand has not grown. Even beyond valuing your brand. Kwani ya uendelee. Kama ulikuwa unavuta sigara ya shilingi mbili. Leo unafaa after success uvuta hata sigara. Kama ulikuwa unakunywa chwara. Kama msanii chipukizi. Leo utaki kupiga ya single malt. Okay, kama ulikuwa unavaa second hand cheap. Leo utaki hata kiatu mpya. There must be growth.
I hear you, bro.
Ama,
DNG.
Because hata tukienda kwa Yesu, Mwenyezi Mungu atatuuliza.
So nilikupatia hii.
Ulifanya nini?
Nilibari uko chini.
Nikaa kwa nyasi, nikaweka chini ya ardhi na nikangoja mpaka urudi. Kwani wasanii wajinga wapumbavu zaidi. Let us push our industry forward. And that is the message that I'm telling my fellow youth. Because it has potential. Wizkid. I interviewed Wizkid when I was at 1FM Kitambo. When he was doing Sugar. Like a small artist. Like a small guy. 1 FM. So, Sugar. Like, I went to the crew and we filmed him on set. And I asked him, how much do you charge? It's about the Nigerian music industry. This is way back. I can't remember the year. But just remember, just go when Sugar was released.
Mm.
And the guy tells me I'm charging about $10,000. $10,000, $5,000 to $10,000 on a good day. So $5,000 was $500K, $10,000 about
NM.
1M. That's then. Eh? Today, do you know how much whiskey is worth?
What's it worth?
It's past $50,000. Past. That's 5 million. So if whiskey has moved from 500,000 to 5 million, and a Kenyan artist is moving from 250 to 70, what is wrong with this economy?
Kuna shida.
And the same brand paying the 250 valued artist at 70 is the same one paying whiskey.
Mm.
And then here locally, unaambiwa hatuna budget. We don't have a budget. Kwanza, there's a client who told me once, you're charging me all this kuongea tu. Unajua, nilimwambia wewe si uongee basi, kuna mdomo na ulimi na unapumua. Ongea.
Talk.
Ongea. Si kampuni ni yako. Ongea basi. Ongelesha watu wasikize. Watu 10,000, 5,000 people on a stage.
Hmm.
Communicate with them and address them and wakunyamaze wakusikize. It's either Raila Odinga, William Ruto, or DNG! Unaelewa?
I get you.
It is command, Baba. And that is the value. That is the value of this entertainment. That ni ukini ukinipeleka Siaya, unipeleke Kitale, unipeleke Kwale, unipeleke Lamu, unipeleke Nyeri, unipeleke Meru, wapi? Na chocha, na chachisha, na kuru, Nairobi. Whether I'm talking to urban, rural, educated, uneducated, drunk, sober, old or young, I will control. Na piga launch ya kampuni, na piga club ya marachets. Zote.
Bro. You know, so
and professionalism, there's something else that we need to talk about. Esther.
Yep. I agree.
The my clients sleep peacefully when they have contacted me. Mm. There are clients who tell me DNG, sutasot. Even the brief they don't give me.
Mm.
I'm told the brand is this, the event is this day at this time. Banga. Even some clients ask me to do the program for them. Activities. DNG, what can we do? I'm in a boardroom giving ideas as if I'm on salary. That is professionalism.
Mm.
And trust, reliability, timeliness, efficiency and effectiveness. That sita kuja nimelewa hata natapika kwa stage. Ama sita kuja nisahau unilipe down payment nizime simu kama wasani wengine. Sunawajua. Walikula down payment ya client tena ni kotini ama unamuliko wa social media. How many artists disappoint clients every single day? And those are the ones bringing our general average down.
Mm.
So a client is like, why should I pay this artist so much for this? So sisi tunapigana, mimi napigana kuendeleza industry yetu, kuitisha bei mzuri, ndo tuenee. Mwingine anaangusha mpira. And unfortunately, when clients look at us, they just look at us collectively.
Yep, we are
balkanized into one conversation as artists. Kenyan artists and uncouth and professional. They are not worth it. They are ineffective. They are. That is why they prefer to bring Nigerians. And I'm not against any nationality. Please don't misconstrue what I'm saying. But like, they will deliver for you. But don't forget the Nigerians even have more strict terms than us.
Mm.
The technical riders from Davido or whoever, P-Square, it's not a joke.
Nope, it's not.
Utapumua. They tell you, I want this champagne, I want this water, I want these towels, this size of cotton. I want this kind of women. It's in the rider.
Yep.
I want this kind of drugs. It's in the rider.
Yo.
Yeah. Not a joke. May I don't mince my words. But a client is willing to pay because of the delivery. It's worth it. So don't we value our craft? That's why for me, a team like Sauti Sol means so much to me, because they keep pushing all forms of boundaries.
Mm.
They are thinking. They have a think tank. They have a company. And that's what we have at 251 Entertainment, the same. It's an agency. We're conceptualizing. I'm sending proposals every single day.
In fact, hold on. Bruh, hey, you vibed, but I love it because it's a conversation that is, first of all, for the young guys, they're being smacked. You get? And they're learning how to they're learning what to do. I say potholes filled up by those who came before me. Mentor, big brother, mad props to DNG. Yeah. Because of you, your journey, what you've done right now, by you explaining your life, you're filling up potholes so that these kids don't go, well, man, easy potholes. Mm. And you're filling them up so that these guys who come after you, they don't engage this thing. So I hope they've listened. Secondly, I love the fact that you brought up the unity collection, understanding that you guys, when you're nation here, it also affects me. Mm. And me, when I'm succeeding here, it also affects you. Because unity is another whole other story. Mm. But I want to go back to your journey. Mm. So that guys don't just listen to what you're saying and not understand the grind you've put. Mm. You know, as we're listening to you, what you've done with Blacks in the club and listening to your journey, mm. guys are like, oh, okay, it's possible. Mm. They're not thinking of how do I quote 300 Gs. They are hearing of you quoting 5 Gs. Mm. They're hearing of you quoting 20, 25,
exactly. 35, 50, 70, 80, 100, 120, 130, exactly. 150, 180, 200, 250. $5,000 and business class tickets. How do you think international gigs pay how much?
No, I get it. I love it. Okay, so Chapa Remix. Let's throw some music up in here. How does that come to be?
So Shazi.
And after that, now we talk about the beginning of your company.
Yeah. So Shazi gave me a call. So Shazi is like Black Star affiliate at the time. And I've interacted with him a couple of times in Karen. At friends' houses and homes and parties and all that. And he's like, yo, man, bring this energy. So Shazi has always been a believer, my brother, man. Big shout out. We talk every once in a while. Mm-hmm. And Shazi tells me, man, we're doing a remix for Chapa. First, Chapa was a hit.
Yeah, hit. Crazy.
Big shout out to Bass. So Shazi had this idea of bringing top names in the industry on one track. So there was myself, Nazizi, Wire, Prezo,
Sheila.
Yeah, Nikki was on that track. I don't know who else was on that track. Like, you know, big names, man. So we mashed it up at the studio. And then we dropped a video, man. A crazy video. So I'm in the video, the guy, broop, 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 broop. I'm that guy, like, I just brought energy and the hype on that track. And, and we did an amazing job.
Sweet. Yeah. Yeah. Back to school now. So in Chuo, you've started first year and in Inini, you haven't. Let's talk about now the formation of the first business that you set up was 254.
Entertainment, yes.
Okay, let's talk about that.